is a Pongame tree fruit. After so many Pongame tree fruits, only few germinate. They turn, you can see the seed have come out, germinated into a new plant. Lot of roots have fallen down, but only few of them have germinated. Here you can see the hard coat, which is the testa, have broken down here, and the seedling have come out. You can see that, how nice it is. It's a Pongame tree. It's a dicotyledonous plant, angiosperm. You can see the brown tegmen. This is a brown tegmen and the cotyledon inside. Okay. And it has given rise to the shoot portion turning to a plumule, turning to a shoot portion, and the radical turning to a root. So this is how. But interesting thing is, they may not all survive because they are below the mother plant. So very less chances of survival. In this case, we can take these seedlings and plant them some other place to reduce the competition. You can see here, the seedling, this will turn to a weak tree, like a Pongame tree, as you get to see here. Huge big tree. And on the same tree, we are also able to see this greenish light green color patches. These green color patches are nothing but they are the lichens. These are lichens. It's an association of alga and fungus, indicator of fresh air, pollution free environment. So these lichens are the indicators of fresh environment. They are the first to grow on the rocks, make them soft by secreting oxalic acid and carbonic acid, and they convert the hard rock into soft rock. They get a chance to grow again, and along with these lichens then grow many cryptogams, many species of alga, bryophytes, and then different grass species start growing along with this alga, moss. Okay, and the entire rock is covered by the foliage. So they are the first initiators to convert the rock into soil, okay, where the vegetation start growing, and then we get to see some seedlings germinating on the soft rock, and these trees then turn to a very nice vegetation where they hold these rock boulders and stop the soil erosion.